In our last chapter, Dag finally called on Eivor, and through his lens of envy, challenged him to a duel. The fictitious demons the old warrior imagined were finally quelled when he died in the battle. Eivor chose to help him to Valhalla, since he at least had the decency to fight him, and not undermine him from the shadows. Our adventure took us up north to Jorvik to visit with two of our old friends, the same ones who left Norway at King Harald Fairhair's meeting. We met Lufina as she dealt with agents of the Order who were trying to kill her. At the King of Jorvik's home, we met Jor, and he introduced us to the King and two other council members, Bedivid and Alden. They had been plagued with issues external and internal. First, we had to figure out why the Order was burning Christian texts or who was doing it. It turned out to be the local abbess Ingeborg, and soon after, she was killed by Eivor. Then we had to divine who the needle was, which led us to the dockmaster who had been swindling the merchants. Deep in the sewers, he was found and we pursued him, before finally killing him in the market, alleviating him of his ill-gotten goods. Then we finally had to figure out who the vault was, and that happened at the Yuletide party. Alden revealed himself to be the traitor, poisoning many nobles there. In the middle of the violence and chaos, he was killed, and that line of ancients was ended. New friends and allies in Jorvik will head to Lincoln today. Let's go tell Ranvi what happened. And meet the pledge again.
Altagate?
Sure.
I have purged the Order of Ancients from Jorvik with Lufina and Hjor's aid. And should we ever need theirs, they will come.
You do this work well, Eivor. Is it a prelude to you joining the Hidden Ones?
I doubt it. Not enough glory in these back-alley brawls.
Agreed. Why don't we go to Lincoln? It's over to the northeast. We can head right on over. More money for me. Good. Alright. Time to make a pledge again.
I want to see the Alliance map.
Alright. I've got some options around here, but we're heading there now.
What about Lincolnshire?
A rather boisterous man named Hunwald arrived recently, wishing to speak with you. On a matter of great importance, he said.
Where is he now?
Down at the docks, carousing with my scouts and scaring the fish from the river. He waits for you with great eagerness.
Okay. That's where we're going today. The story goes on. And a new outfit.
Sounds charming. I will meet him at once.
Protect your ears.
I want it to look like, I don't know, some crazy looking dwarf king. You can tell by my axe and what I'm wearing. I thought I would go for something a bit more eccentric. I've been trying a bit more when it comes to the tattoos and even a few hairstyles too from time to time.
Hey there, how are you?
Yeah, how are you? Go away, kid. I'm not chatting with you. All right, Hytham is right over here.
I am sorry for what happened with Dag. It could not have been easy. May he rest in peace.
Jorvik is now free of the Order's influence.
Brilliant as ever, my friend. Thank you for all you have done. Ah, here is something for you. An odd letter arrived a few days ago, signed by one calling himself...
A poor fellow soldier of Christ.
That's right. Someone you know.
Not by sight. But this soldier has intimate knowledge of the Order. He's the reason I've found them so easily in the cities.
The letter says you must travel to Winchester, visit God's house, and look for a man in white. Then recite this passage. When pride cometh, then cometh shame. But with the lowly cometh wisdom.
All right. I'll speak with Randvi, get a fuller picture of all this.
Do you need something?
Keep this. It serves your cause better than it does my pocket.
It gives me joy to take these from you. As a token of my deep gratitude, I want you to have this. Keep this up and the land will be free of these monsters.
You're no kidding.
I have to go.
Then go in peace.
That I shall. Hytham has actually been really cool with me. I like him a lot. In comparison to a lot of people who have not been as wholesome towards me as they probably should be. Alright, that fella we've got a chat with is right over here. Let's go find out what he wants.
Isn't it, men? Life in the rough, in the company of friends, sitting beside a carefree river. You may think this odd, but our lively chatter here has inspired in me a short poem. May I recite it for you?
Go on, Lord the Boy. Make me tremble.
Oh, indeed, I shall try. I call it Ode to a Hungry Flame.
Another Skald come to join us.
Me? Oh, goodness, no. I'm no Skald, no. Just a humble nobleman with an interest in versification. An amateur, really. Shall I continue?
I'm not here to judge your poems, Lord. Speak your purpose or down your mead.
Yes. Sorry. I have come with the hope of meeting Eivor, the great warrior of this clan. If such an audience is possible.
You're talking with him now, and you are?
Ah, by God's blood! My day begins with a lash of good fortune. I am Hunwald, loyal son of Lord Hunbeor, the current Ealdorman of Lincolnshire. May God keep and cure him. You see, my father is ailing, and in his delirium, evil men have corrupted his judgment. A secret and powerful order, if the whispers are true. Only a month ago, without forewarning, Mercian soldiers chased me, his only son, from my home. I know not why, but I do know my father would never have ordered my exile.
Outcast from your family. That's a hard road to walk.
Could one of your clan help me return to Lincoln? March beside me through the city gates and set me at my father's noble feet once again.
It may be we can help you, but we'll want something in return. An alliance between our clan and yours.
And you shall have it. My father is a great friend of the Danes in spite of the recent wars.
You sing a sad song, Hunwald of Lincolnshire. A son robbed of his father's protection, now desperate to prove his honor. How far will you go to regain it? To a bloody end?
Oh, indeed. I will plunge into the heat of battle to defend my father, knowing our cause is a righteous one.
All right, young lord. My clan has need of me just now. But when I'm ready, we'll find your father together and right the wrongs you've suffered.
God praise you, Eivor.
I won't be leading you into the heart of the shield wall, but there will be danger. I want your word. You will follow my orders to the ruin.
I am yours to abuse.
If it comes to that.
I'll wait for you in my safe haven, Bottleston, to the northeast. From there, we shall make our way to Lincoln.
Goodbye, Lord Boy. Safe travels.
God bless and keep you all.
I fear I may be escorting that boy to his own execution.
That might shut him up.
Good one. Okay, the Lay of Hunwald. Our new arc has now begun. That's where we're going, for sure. All right, let's see. How far is it? I should be able to get out there rather easily. Oh, right over here. Yeah, right by the docks. Cool. Our friend's probably going to be up here. I mean, where else would he be? The guy is pretty strange, and I'm going to have to keep him alive. I have seen a few hostile soldiers around me.
Drinking and jabbering as always.
So this is Hunwald's safe haven.
Though we be a Mercian Shire today, tomorrow the Kingdom of Lindsay will rise again. As free as the wind on the back of my neck.
Your line of kings died long ago, Hunwald. We're in Lincolnshire now. Do you need a map to remember?
Alfgar, my dear man, I do not need a map to prove what my bones know for truth.
Oh boy. Ambitious.
Hunwald, who is this stranger?
Eivor, come, sit. Bread and ale, please, alewife. I have been discussing my delicate situation with Alfgar here.
Lord.
He is a nobleman like me, one of Lincolnshire's sturdy thanes.
Hunwald's idea of sturdy is a mug of ale that won't tip over.
Alfgar has pledged his loyalty to my family, the House of the Ferocious Swan. With his influence and your might, we shall rid Lincolnshire of the ruffians who plague this land, once and for all.
We're going to see your father, Hunwald, that's all.
Indeed, Eivor. With speed and purpose, you are the axle to my wheel, the spark to my tinder.
Hunwald, your father's ill, and your enemies have every advantage under the sun. Do you have a plan, or have I come all this way to watch you drink this watery piss?
Of course, my friend. I am a man of action above all else, ready to leap and dance and fight.
Listen, I've come to escort you to your father's side. We go now, or I walk?
Ah, yes, to Lincoln, away! But with care. The road between here and there is teeming with brigands who wish me dead.
You daft lump of lard. A single Dane will not protect you against the whole of Mercia's army.
I think you're wrong, Alvgar. And here he'll prove it.
I'm hot for a fight, Snowdog. Give me half a chance, I'll stove your heathen face right in!
Have you ever seen a blood eagle, my Saxon friends?
A what?
A blood eagle. A raw, magnificent bird I'll tear from your guts. First, I crush your ribs. Then I pull out your lungs and stretch them into wings, so you can fly to your heaven as fast as possible.
Jesus fucking heathen.
You canny fox. That was incredible. Like watching a captain navigate the roiling waters of an angry river. I must void my bladder, Eivor. Then we shall set forth in search of adventures new.
You travel with a marked man at your side.
He's with me. He'll be fine.
If I had a scribe jot down all the occasions I'd warn that stupid boy, I'd be the most written about man in history.
Alfgar, the boorish nag of Lincolnshire.
Got him. Huh.
Oh, told Hunwald to stay near. Where did he wander off to?
That's what I want to know. Oh, he's in trouble. Okay. I better go take out the local soldiers here. There's one.
Look at him. Soft as unbaked bread.
Keep chatting, keep chatting.
Leave me be.
All right. Only two more to kill. Like that guy.
Leave him be.
Ho ho ho. It is done today. All right. Let's chat.
I live. I am alive. Heaven have mercy.
Are you hurt?
Unbelievable. The Battle of Bottlestone will be remembered for years to come. Alfgar, we have won our first great victory.
Hunwald, are you hurt?
Never better, I...
We should get to Lincoln as quickly as we can.
Yes, yes, you're right. Let's depart. What horrible souls are hunting me? Me, the son of a beloved Ealdorman. Was it naive to believe my status as a nobleman held some sway over the chaerls and serfs of this shire? What cause have any to dishonor me? Look! Boats there! We could sail the waters to Lincoln, sink the ship...
What were you told when the guards exiled you?
Oh, scraps of nonsense. I woke to screaming. A man grabbed me, said I was an immediate danger to my father. Ha! Horse pucky! Mercian soldiers then shackled me, rode me blindfolded to the River Wash, and told me plainly, start anew elsewhere or face death in Lincolnshire.
What did they mean?
Oh, some nonsense about me praying for his...
Hold on now. They're fighting each other. I'm not really interested. Let's go. Tell me more, kiddo. Come on.
Oh, some nonsense about me praying for his death. Hungry for his inheritance.
Speak plainly, Hunwald. I can't help you if I don't know the full story. You hold no grudge against your father?
No, never. No, I suspect the order for my exile came from on high. Perhaps one of Burgred's final orders before he was deposed.
That would surprise me. Burgred was battling Danes until the end. He had bigger things to worry over.
Perhaps you're right. He's too contained. It must have been King Alfred, then.
King Alfred of Wessex? That's another kingdom entirely.
Yes, but Alfred has a fearful hatred of the Danes. He must have heard that I am courting one. A beauty who knows no equal.
Your Dane lady love. Right.
Oh, come on, man. All right. I could ride right through them, but why don't we take our time?
The city of my birth, the cauldron of my present sorrows.
No kidding. All right, let's kill him. That's one. I just want to kill two, man. At least two. Ooh. All right, that was devastating, buddy. I'll never recover. I'll never recuperate. I'm kidding. Let's go. That's a devastating attack. And it's over. Whenever I get to a new city, I've got to plant my flag, you know. All right. I'm gonna fight my way through. I don't want them hitting him or...
Mercian guards everywhere. Follow me.
Right behind you, Shadow Walker. My heart beats like the drums of your dragon.
Are they bothering people? I believe they are. Well, we can't have much of that, can we? Goodbye. Alright, he's gone. I don't want to hit the nearby people.
So harsh and unwanting.
Got him.
Not Lincoln. I shall make you...
I don't know about that, man, but, you know, I'll try to help you out. I could use a friend, even an idiot for a friend, I suppose. Alright, so we just need to watch out for a few more guards, correct? Let's have a look. Not here. Okay, that's good. Can I get in through this way? Do they want me to? They might want me to go through the main door, I don't really know.
Hunwald! Praise God, you live! I do, my dear Reaganhair, body and soul. Tell my father his son has returned and in fighting form. It is urgent I speak with him.
I'm sorry, Lord, but your father has been taken.
Taken? When?
Weeks ago, Lord. And well ill he was when they carried him off. I wish I could say more.
Have you looked for him?
Oh, I dare not go asking after him, for fear of stepping above my caste. But he'll be in good hands, don't you worry. Up there with the Abbess and her sisters and all.
He still has friends in Lincoln. That's a good sign.
Bishop Herivrith among them. He's kept a vigil at the town hall, looking after things in your father's absence until he returns.
Will we find trouble there? At the town hall?
You mean soldiers and the like? Aye. There have been many, many more about since your father took his leave.
Right. We'll find a quiet way in if we can.
Okay. Is it really far? Well, hold on. Before we can chat about that, we've got some fighting to do. All right. That's what you want to do. Hey, kid, you might want to get out of here. Things are not looking great. Here, let me roll a little bit. I'm not really taking a lot of damage. I'll be okay. All right, but here's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna break right through that shield. Yeah, frickin' fool. Ooh. Just don't catch me on fire. Come on. I need to get out the way, I think. All right, let's get him now. Whoa. That was a close one. I actually wanted to catch it, but that's okay. Got him. Just making my way up the stairs. Nothing happened here. Nothing violent.
He's an old fixture of my family's household. Loyal to the end. He helps run the place, and he's known me since I was but a little lordling. A simple fellow, but worth every pinch of his salt.
Good to know. Okay. I suppose we've got more to fight. I probably didn't need to go this way, but I'm choosing to. Let's get one of them. Ooh, not gone yet. Again, I'm trying to watch out for nearby people, too. Oh, another one. I'm just a flag planter, you know? You know what? I'm not gonna lock on. Who needs to do that? Not me.
probably a bad habit to even have that, you know, used.
Ooh. Lincoln seems a good place to trade.
Does it?
The market is flush with goods.
Yes, it must be. Growing up, we never wanted for anything in my father's home. Bread and poultry and field fruits of all manner. I suppose this is where our servants purchased them. Lincoln's boon was ours as well.
How often did you leave your house, Hunwald?
Not very often, it seems. Let's get him again. Gotta hurry up, you know? Ooh, that was a good hit, I suppose. They got me, which is a good hit for them. All right, let's break through his shield if we can. Ooh, didn't quite get there, did I? All right, you know what? I'm gonna move over here. Oh yeah, he's not okay. Come on, open up. Got him. All right, let's get the other guy now. Got it. That's what I was looking for. I love doing that too. All right, let's break through now. That's even better than the flag. All right, let's get him back up. And he's weak.
How often did you leave your house, Hunwald?
Oh, from time to time. Yes.
He didn't, no. Poor guy. He was a shut-in. All right, we've made it. Good news.
My lord, you're well.
Lord Hunwald, you should have sent forewarning of your return to avoid the violence that dogs you. Lives might have been spared.
Why so surprised to see my return, Bishop? Was I rumored dead?
Oh, worse than dead. It is my reluctant duty to report the rumor that you were lost in the north, bedding a Dane on some squalid farm.
I'm not the Dane has been plowing, and I don't own a farm.
I know you mean well, Bishop, but there's no cause to insult Swanborough's honor. You leave my lady love out of this.
Ah, your mystery Dane has a name. Sadly, the people of the Shire will hardly be comforted. Now that you have swelled your father's tolerance for pagans into a sin.
I have no patience for insult and rumor. We have come to speak with Lord Hunbjord, that is all.
Lord Hunbjord has gone, I'm afraid. He would not say where to, but I'm sure he will return shortly. Once the storm has passed.
What on earth do you mean by that? What storm?
Your father feared for his life, Hunwald. In his weakened state, he could not defend himself. Not against the Dane, certainly.
How dare you? Eivor is above reproach.
See this from my view, Hunwald. You arrive after a strange absence, with a hired Viking in tow, demanding to see your father. This does not, in my estimation, imply benign intentions.
Oh boy.
Hunwald has seen the point of a dagger more than once this week. I'm only here to protect him.
Your father was at my hospice for some days, and very well treated. But he left in secret. That's all we know.
In secret? That's odd. He's not one to scurry about in the dark.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. We have searched high and low for him, but to no avail. Come, Abbess. We should leave this young lord to his scurrying thoughts. There is nothing more of use we can say to him.
Take care, my boy.
Stay within these walls where you're safest. I'll have a look around, see what I can learn about your father.
If my father spent time at the hospice here, the healers who work there may know something. Talk to them if you can. Find out what they know.
I do want to help him out. He's a goofball, but I don't want him to die. Okay. We need to go around. I've got more skill points too. Even better. Go and chat with a few healers. Okay, we're not too far now. I feel like that bishop is definitely a member of the order. He has really too much to gain by being involved here, so I don't trust him at all. I really do not.
Hunwald's father was recuperating here not long ago. Someone may have seen him depart.
Yeah, and we're gonna find out who it was.
But I need to be able to get inside.
Need to get on the other side.
Strange right now. Oh, pardon me. I'm getting around. Don't you mind me. Oh, easy enough. I got you. Let's chat with her. Are there more guards in here?
Do you know where your Ealdorman is?
I can tell you a few things, but not here in the open. Follow me.
Okay, sure. I'm waiting. Do you want to move a little bit? I'm wondering if she's waiting for all, like, the guards to go away. No, she's just very old. I gotcha. Who's humming? Oh, that guy. Okay, he's very loud. He's like, I want people to know that I'm chilling out here, doing some work. Alright. In here? Oh, further. Okay. Probably in here, then. I gotcha. Oh, hold on. Before we talk to her. I'll take that. Thank you.
This is far enough. Tell me what you know.
Oh, I know loads of things about our Ealdorman. I know his favorite foods. I know when his bedclothes get changed. And I know he hates being bled with leeches. That sort of thing.
But where has he gone?
Ah, where? I have no bloody idea. Is that what you asked me?
Forget it.
Oh, you're kidding me. Okay, well, I did find that, so good for me. Let's keep on chatting.
Are you the head sister?
Please, don't hurt me. These poor souls need me.
Calm, sister. Lord Hunwald sent me. He asked me to speak with the people here.
Hunwald? That's not a name I expected to hear again.
No harm will come to you or those you care for. I'm only looking for your Ealdorman.
I'd be risking my neck telling you anything. And if my head rolls, these sick and ailing folk will follow me to the grave.
Your Ealdorman would agree. So the sooner I find him, the more quickly these prowling guards will leave your hospice.
That's a pleasant thought. Our lord was in a bad way here, and getting worse, in spite of our efforts. Then, quite against my instruction, some guards moved him out. I overheard them talking about a bathhouse. There's no working bathhouse in Lincoln. So, I gather they meant the old ruins just south of here, by the eastern walls.
Ruins just south of here. I'll look there. Thank you.
I pray you find him. He's in desperate need of care.
Yeah, hopefully I can help out. Alright, it's not too far away. Gotta watch out for the guards. I mean, things are very hostile here. They're not too tough for me, but there are a lot of standard bearers. I mean, a lot of them. They're like, I gotta plant my flag, and you need to know where. Well, I've been planting my flag instead. Oh, we're down. Cool. Very convenient. I didn't even know it was down there. Alright, so, hearing bells right now. The bells would drive me crazy if I wasn't used to them. Could you imagine that, having to hear bells all the time? Not really a common occurrence for you, then out of nowhere. A bell. Okay, so we're going inside of there. I might as well just climb up, I suppose. Uh-oh. Okay, we've got to go down there now.
God punishes those who wish ill upon... upon... go on.
Ill upon who?
Eh? Oh, sorry, I was miles away. What?
Okay, interesting people. Very interesting. Let's kill him. Didn't take long at all. Are there more for me to kill? There's got to be, right? That doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if that's true or not. Anyway... let's jump on down. Hopefully I won't need that. Knowing my luck and my foolishness, I probably shall. Oh, right there, yeah. I'm gonna need something around here. I don't have full adrenaline. That's really funny. But there's another. See, they plant around people like me who like to blow things up. I can't help it. It keeps me warm. Oh, that popped up. Okay, well. Anyway, yoink. Ooh, I'm gonna catch on fire. Gotta watch out. Oh, okay. I'll take that. Thank you. Not quite what I came here for, but I don't mind taking it. Alright, so I'm going down. I gotcha. Ooh, it's really dark. Back into the sewers again. The rats who are around. causing issues.
These tunnels run deep. Was the Ealdorman fleeing to a hideaway beneath Lincoln?
Yeah, maybe.
Damn it.
Oh, gross. Okay. Hey, don't get it on me. Oh. All right, cool. He's dead. Still peeing, I think. Killing a man during a piss. There's got to be a law against that somewhere. All right, let's go on down and through. What's in here? Ooh, stuff for me to eat. I'm glad it wasn't poison. That would have been awful for me. Right, so we've got to go further in. Do I go around? I do. There's got to be more enemies around here somewhere, right? Who knows? I might have gone through circles. Uh-oh. That'll make noise. Oh. You're not fully aware, are you? Alright, I need to kill you. Oh, not quite dead. There we go. Much better.
This area is off limits.
So we've made it inside. I'm gonna grab a few arrows while I'm here.
More Mercians traipsing across our routes. Can't piss from here to Bolingbroke without some.
Bye now. Oh no, that fell. Maybe don't have this right above your head. Very bad idea. Okay, so we're still moving. I'm gonna take my time and just kill a few of them. I mean, I could easily fight through them all. I've done it before multiple times. Yeah, I might actually do a few after today, just quietly. Just for the hell of it. Is it needed? Not really. I mean, I'm a freaking Viking. I'm not a hidden one. Let's get him. I mean, I do shoot quickly. Is he trying to sling at me? Hey, slinger, no slinging. Alright. Oh, no, no, no. Let's kill that person instead. It's much more important to me. Boink. They're gone. Oh, shoot. That got in the way. Hilarious. Ooh. That's a lot of dirt. You like challenges. Me too. Alright, anyway. I've been in here already. I remember coming in here. It was like last week, though, so I don't remember all of it. Ooh. That was a devastating attack on him. Got him! I'm always getting ahead. Alright, so we got keys over there, and I've got to find a way to get over there to begin with. Let's find out how I'm going to do that today. Let's see here. I suppose I'll go up and go around. There's bound to be more of them. I mean, that just leads up. I know. Man. Lots of food up here for me to eat. They're just trying to feed me. Yeah, maybe over here and then I go back down. I don't know. Or maybe it leads out. If not, I would like double back and figure it out. It's a pretty big area. Wait, no. I'm getting closer. Cool. Nice. I found a spring, too. It's beautiful here. Uh-oh.
There was fighting here. About what?
Yeah, about what? There's a moving key. That's interesting.
A violent struggle between nobles and bandits. The bandits didn't fare so well.
No, they did not. All right, let's keep on looking. It's over here.
A noble's cloak with the image of a swan. Looks like the Ealdorman passed this way.
What a frickin' attack, though. Dear sweet heavens. He can't be alive, can he? Let's keep on looking around. Alright, so I'm about to go that way. There's a key right down there, which is really interesting. Let's keep on looking this way before I move on. Now, what is it all about? I'm gonna make it to the other side in just a moment. Got my torch out. Any clues over here? That's what I need to know. Right, I do need a freaking key. And that key is going to be... Where's it at again? I know it's underwater, but... Okay, cool. Oh. Okay. I've got to go down over here. I gotcha. I was wondering. I was like, hold on, that's not very deep at all. You better not try to kill me.
I know a lonely door that would love to meet this key.
Oh yeah, no kidding. Cool. Very convenient. I don't know who builds all of that, but man, they make my life much easier. Alright, let's come over here now. And we got him. Alright. More clues for me, the clue hound. Let's have a look. Orvin, we have received an offer from an unnamed Saxon requesting safe passage through the sewers to Bolingbroke. The amount is considerable, which leads me to believe they have something of great value they cannot afford to be seen with. Interesting.
A Saxon nobleman paid some bandits for permission to sneak through these tunnels on their way to Bolingbroke Castle. Mercian nobles made a deal with some bandits, paid them hush money to let them sneak through these caves. When the time came, the bandits ambushed the nobles. But it didn't end well for the bandits. In the struggle, the Ealdorman's cloak was torn off. But he got away and headed east for Bolingbroke Castle. That's my best lead.
Okay. Cool. Now we need to go talk to the Ealdorman. We're not too far away. I've made it over to the castle, but I'm not going to go through the front gate. I'm going to try to find another way inside if I can. It's a fairly large area. Now, what do we have over here? It can't be open, right? No. But my dive of the Valkyrie has an AoE effect, which means it'll break open that door. I'm not meant to be here, but I'm glad I'm here. All right, what's over there? That's what I need to know. Let's find out. Get it. Oh, hold on. I don't want to catch on fire. I'll come back later. I'm not in a big rush. Oh, what happened down here?
That keep is well protected.
Okay. Can I read anything down here? It won't let me. Probably not meant to be here just yet. But that's okay. I'm meant to be right over here. Perfect. Alright. Let's try to kill some people. Hi there. Do you like fire? I like fire. Not that much. Alright, buddy. Let's do it. Ooh, close one. I've got a flaming fist, which is really interesting, I think. Let's get it. Ooh, I was hoping for like a super punch. Punch, punch, punch. I don't know why I'm doing that, but I thought it would be funny. Oh, I can actually hit that. Cool. Did I get your friend? I don't think I did. Oh god, he's still burning. That's really brutal. Alright, let's see. Don't hit me! I dropped it perfectly. That was really nice. Let's try to get him. Alright. I don't even need my weapon in my dominant hand. Nice one. I'll switch it later. I'm busy right now. We have only a few more to kill. Let's do it. Alright, he's down. Shoot him a few times. He's dead too. Who else is left? Well, I'll jump again. Punch. Alright. I got him. I just need a few more hits, I think. Nah, I'll use my bow. Okay. Now to find that man. I have a feeling he's dead. Can I trigger it if I run out, then run back in? Alright, let's find out. No, not yet. I hope I didn't break it. I think I broke it. Yeah, they want me to find him. There we go.
There now, my lord. All is prepared. Shall we begin the washing? Hey, who comes? Welcome, stranger. Are you here to pay tribute to our Lord Ealdorman?
I heard voices as I entered. Were you speaking with him? Does his hooger speak through you?
I am not sure what to call it precisely. Words form in my mind, and I give them voice. Often they sound like my dear lord.
Can I ask a favor of him, on behalf of his son, Hunwald?
You could try, but he never speaks when others are present.
Hunwald deserves to know the truth about his father's fate. He is owed an inheritance, and deserves a chance to become Ealdorman himself.
All in good time, I imagine.
No, now.
When the guards put him in my care,
I was told to keep all this a secret. Until the appointed time. When I asked who gave these orders, they struck me. I wish I could say more.
I've seen all I need to, but Hunwald will need proof.
Of course. You're welcome to search through his effects, though I'm not sure what trinket would best serve your purpose.
I'll find something.
She's kind of crazy. Let's have a look.
Foul rat droppings everywhere.
Even in death, my lord is a friend to all of God's creatures.
Ugh. Okay. The genealogy. Interesting. Our kings who under God and willed and ruled shall be remembered. Oh, a final name.
I don't know what this is, and I'd rather not ask.
Yes, I thought the same. Troubling.
Okay, lady.
Dried herbs and berries crushed into powder.
The time between my lord's departure and his burial is longer than usual. My lord must keep up appearances for his upcoming rites.
Okay, her journal. Left him here, they did. Weak and frail. Carried him by his arms, feet dragging behind. Drop him on the floor with a thud. No way to... Okay. Man.
A box of musty clothing. And a brooch with a crest. The house of the ferocious swan. This will do. I'll return this brooch to Hunwald and Lincoln. I hope the poor boy can withstand such ill news.
Yeah, now before we go, let's have a look in here. What is it? Some basic treasure, I suppose. Okay. Like, junk. Not only junk, but some coin. I'll take it. Alright, let's leave now. Hunwald, I'm back. I've got bad news for you, kid. Goody's here. I was worried about him.
Eivor! What news?
Your father's dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Hunbjörn's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnshire. He cannot be gone. He...
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer. Do you hear me? I am a man and I am my father's son. Do not forget it.
Keep steady, Hunwald. You're now the head of your house.
Another swan takes flight. Only I remain. Last in a line of... dwindling nobles.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord, have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Hunwald was the son of an Ealdorman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a shire moot. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your shire moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot. But between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
We have a similar custom, what we call an Althing. An assembly of good folk.
With so many like habits, there should be peace between our people and yours. Perhaps that begins now.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the Ealdorman's seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. and I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and we'll convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word, if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan? Oh,
I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my God commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Hunbjorth's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archer went to console him. I should follow her.
Yeah, where she's at? She's over here somewhere. Okay, I gotcha. I'm welcome here. Maybe you shouldn't be hostile to me now, guards. Well, let's head on down and find her. Yeah, I'll do that. I need to know more. That bishop I do not trust at all. Not even a little. Hi, lady.
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
See here.
What devil put you up to all this deception?
I wasn't put up, Eivor. I felt compelled to carry on for the good of the Shire. Until I knew the truth.
A pretty answer for an ugly lie.
Yeah, I don't appreciate that. You shouldn't have done that. Man, could you imagine being lied to? Horrible, man. Alright, let's get that guy. And you. Oh, definitely you, pal. Let's see, how am I going to do it? Oh, I know. Perfect. Not quite sufficient, but I'm getting closer to where I need to be. Alright, let's back up. I need more stamina. Come on, pal. Look at me. Woohoo! That was an okay shot, I think. Let's get him. Open up. Got him. That's a very powerful attack. Alright, so I did level up again. I'm gonna go meet the kid. The kid is... Oh, not a kid. A grown man. I'm doing it too! Oh, he's way up here. Okay, that's not too far from where I need to go anyway. Oh, legendary hunt. We'll probably have like one part where we focus on a lot of those. I think that'll be fun. Let's go talk to the kid now.
That must be the tree Archer mentioned. Hunwald may be nearby.
Well, he's gotta be. There's a horse right there. I might choose him. I feel like he might grow up quite a bit. No one really did help him.
These woods, father. Oh, these woods. I remember the days we spent here together. Here, upon this spot. Ducking and hiding through the rushes, with bow and arrow, chasing rabbits and squirrels. 1,000 arrows I fired, and 100 trees I bled. But not a single animal could I catch. All of them fled.
Hmm. Okay, now.
Hello? Eivor? Is that you?
Yeah, it's me. Give me a moment. Very rude, by the way. Out of nowhere, man.
Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald.
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate. The view.
Be easy with your grief, Hunwald. If you're not careful, it's a poison you'll bear in your blood for the rest of your life.
No need to worry. For I have found the antidote for it.
Do not gorge on grief.
nor give in to sadness, but let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting, and I would catch the most wretched little things if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast. To you, Hunwald. You have love in your heart and hope in your eyes. That's more than many can say.
Eivor, I can't begin to...
All right, Lord. You are all right. Skull!
Skull! And then my father says it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end! Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humor, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right, your Dane lady love. She sounds lovely. Too lovely to be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Yeah, no kidding. Don't you attack me again. All right.
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You've never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound? Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter? Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You can't grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, your countryside does take the breath away.
Quite so. I love this land. And should I follow my father's footsteps, I shall do my solemn duty to protect her. I know many think me foolish, inexperienced, but I would ask that they judge me by my future hopes, not my past reputation. If I am given sway over this land and show myself to be a poor leader, shame me, punish me, of course, but give me that chance. My God, I just want to have that chance.
You're gonna have it, kid. I'm gonna give it to you. Don't worry about that. Uh-oh.
What was that?
Birds, Eivor. Has no one told them today is a day of grief?
Shh. Quiet.
See one guy there. We're gonna be ambushed. They're here
Stop
to kill
here.
Him.
Something isn't right. I'll Let's find the trouble before it finds us.
Yeah, I need to do that.
I am sweating from head to toe.
Oh, hi. It's you. Dead guy. I remember you. I feel like I've seen you before, too.
Stay calm.
Oh, stay very, very calm.
Now, time to fight, Hunwald! Now!
It is your time, kiddo. Who's left? Oh, we got a few more left. Okay, sure. Like that guy. He's dead. Let's get the other one. Man, all of you are just not very creative. I've got to tell you that now. You're not very good at what you do.
You'll suffer for that.
Is he in trouble already? Alright, hold on. I'll make it. He's dead? Don't you kill the kid on me. I'll be ticked off. Very ticked off.
Who sent you? Speak or be damned.
Ah, here we go. I see him now. Let's lock it up. Come on. Boom. That's a lot of damage. Take your damage and enjoy, you bunch of idiots. Oh, you didn't know that I was here. All right, fool. One more dead. Look, that kid has grown on me, and I'm going to give him a chance. He's lost a lot. You're not going to kill him here. And also, everyone's trying to kill him. He's still here, too. Yeah, not a problem. Let's go, buddy. Let's go.
That's twice they've tried to kill you, Hunwald.
And twice failed.
We had luck. But if you're not more careful, they will succeed. Someone in Mercia wants you dead. And they'll kill anyone in the way to see it done.
Yes, including my dear Swanborough, my lady love. Come, let us hurry away.
I'm serious, Hunwald. Are you hearing me?
Plain and clear. Follow me.
Hunwald, are you sure this place is safe?
The safest spot in the Shire, yes. Here I am with a chance to be Ealdorman, but I have yet to prove myself worthy. To you, to the Shire, to her. I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself.
Is it an actual person? Huh. Okay. I hope it is. Better not be a goat, man. I'll be mad. Alright, now how far is it? I have no idea. I'm gonna follow him. Hopefully. Oh, we should be there now, I think. And we are back. Grimsby. Let's follow him, though. Gotta do that much.
Follow my voice, Bjarte!
Huh? Okay.
Oh, thank the heavens! There she is!
Oh, no. Okay.
Hunwald, I thought for sure you'd be dead. Why didn't you send word?
It has been far too long, my little jewel. I'm so very sorry for that.
I'm fine, my love. I wilted without you, but still I grow. And who is this?
Ah, yes. I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Hello, Eivor. A pleasure to meet you.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A shire moot will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here, out of sight, until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love? Forget my father's seat. What if I stayed here with you? Just the two of us.
Hunwald, no. This Shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the Shire as he did.
Whatever strength you lack, you have in Swanborough. Heed her advice.
Yes. If anyone can lift my spirits in time for the Shire moot, it's you, my dear.
Come inside and rest your bumbling bones, love. Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Yeah, sure, not a problem.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I don't doubt it.
I like her. Very kind lady. Okay. I was worried that it wasn't an actual person. But all is well. While I'm here, I'll take what I can. Okay, all mine. My lady love. Oh no, I'm not gonna read all of that. Not me. Not doing it, pal. Anyway, let's go see. I've got to do a job again. Alright, I need to go talk to him now.
Eivor.
I'm pleased you came.
Yeah, me too.
Welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Elfgard, it's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved Ealdorman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
It's a beautiful weapon, finely crafted. Thank you.
I thought you might like it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moats. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see.
Okay.
To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has been badgering my estate for weeks. I must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear?
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is all but ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. But today, the shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Ealdorman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you. What little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herifriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damned decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were terrified.
Are we hunting, Elfgar? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely. The bear's lair should be nearby.
Okay, sure.
Grim. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right. Very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
It is good to meet you, Grim.
Hey, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Elfgard claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we? There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
I don't like him. He's trying to butter me up, and I hate that a lot. Oh, hello. Very spacious.
This is the threshold of the beast's home. There's no doubting.
Whoa. Okay.
This is the threshold of a beast's home. There's no doubting that.
Yeah, why don't we watch out for a brief moment? I can take care of him. I'm not too worried about a few wolves.
That's not a bear. Wolves.
A lot of them. Holy crap. Grim, are you okay? I hope you're okay, buddy. I haven't seen you for a moment. Anyway. Is that what you wanted? For me to help you get rid of wolves? Okay, they're gone now. Hopefully Grim didn't die to a bear or whatever else might be out here. We got separated, evidently. Oh, okay.
There's something you'll want to see here.
Is that? That smoke? My god! My estate is burning like a twig!
Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but please! My god, help me with this!
I'm in this fight with you. A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me.
Man, you sound a bit like Dag. Huh. I like you more than Dag. I think I want to bring him with me, you know? All right, home. Meet Grim. He's not dagged. That's my selling point for him.
Help! Someone waited until you were away to set your world aflame.
They will attack on sight here.
I'll get him. Don't worry about it. All right, how many am I killing? At least a few of them, right? Yeah. Get closer. Come on. Ho-ho.
There's nowhere to eat it. The house is burned, Eivor.
Let's catch a few of them on fire. I can do that much. And I'm going to jump up and deal more damage. Oh, I'm doing a lot to them. Whoa, nice one, buddy. Very nice. But goodbye. Okay, he's dead. I don't want to catch myself on fire. I'm very good at it, though. I'm very good at catching myself on fire. Yep, see? Oh, man. All right, we did it. That's over. That was quick, too. Damn. Oh, wait, wait. There's more. Never mind. It's not over yet. Let me help out. Just need to hit that. I need to try to, anyway. Come on. Just gotta get your foot or something. Ah, forget it. Forget about it, man. It's okay. Let's just kill him. You'll have my what? Sorry. That was pretty good. Oh, I think he was in my way. Well, shoot. Catch that one, then. Oh, his head popped off. Cool. They were backing up for a moment. All right, let's do it. Let's get this guy. Oh, his knees. They're not feeling good anymore. You idiot. Got him. But did I get them all? I think I did.
The men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Alfgard. You can rebuild.
To be sure. But I do not look forward to the toilet. Sweet Lord in heaven! The bear is returned!
The Shire mood will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well.
That's really funny. That's really good. I love that. Let's get rid of the bear. Come on. Bad bear. No bear, you can't stay. Okay, I got it. The bear's gone. The quickest hunt ever. Alright, so we need to go talk to her. Do we have another quest? Oh yeah, it's gone. Yeah, we'll go talk to her. I need to lay down a few more points too. Hunter bow combo. Okay, I've got that one. It's a very good one. Adrenaline, I do want that. We'll head down over here. I've gotten a lot. Most of the abilities I do want to have anyway. She's right up here. She's not too far. We'll go talk to her. It's incredible how much that we've got to do. I mean, we're a little bit over halfway through, according to the little chart, which is wild to me. But hey, that means we've got a lot more to enjoy together. Now, here she is, where the stone falls.
Archer, is everything ready?
The Shire Moot will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yes, I'm curious to see this Shire Moot for myself. I'll follow.
Let's go.
When will the boat begin, Abbas?
12 able lords of Lincolnshire have already cast their stones, but they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
It's an important vote for your people. How would you counsel my vote?
I value competent and righteous leadership, not foolish friends in high seats.
Anyone but Hunwald, you mean?
I love Hunwald as I love my own kin. But I would not put a stone in his care without fearing for the safety of both. I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
It is definitely the devil. Anyway, I'll go talk to a few people around here before we make our votes.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord. Have you any advice before our vote?
Lord Hundbeor was a bold and honest man, if somewhat reckless. I see the same qualities in his son. Therefore, Hunwald is my man.
Oh, hey, how about that? One for the kid.
King Ceolwulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today shall have his full blessing.
He's learning fast. Good man.
There we go. Okay. If only that was his boy over here, but he would have been busy as an alderman. Oh well.
Grim, good to see you again.
A hearty hello, Drengir. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking her shores.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Elfgard is a friend of yours, is he not?
He is, and a good man as well. But I cast my stone for the bishop.
The bishop? That's an odd strategy.
These Christians are easy to nudge about. So desperate they are to avoid a good fight, they'll agree to most anything a Dane says.
Yeah, I know, trust me, it's like we're their saviors. I've got many opinions about that, but I'll save them for later.
Good evening, Elfgard.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit your support, but I do need it. The vote is closer than a cat's whisker.
It's a difficult choice, Elfgard. Know that I won't make it lightly.
Good, good. But let me say unreservedly that I am the man who will lead Lincolnshire into progress and victory.
I don't doubt your convictions, Lord.
I do not. Keep on chatting.
Hunwald will return the house of the ferocious...
Bishop.
Eivor, I must thank you for your fearless participation in our moot.
I'm surprised to hear you vouch for me, Bishop.
I surprised myself, to be honest. But I felt it would be a good test of God's faith in my judgment. Under my guidance, this Shire is crawling back from a decade of lawlessness. God knows the love that lives in my heart for the people of Lincolnshire. I pray now that he guides your hand accordingly.
Quite a gambit, Bishop. Mad enough to work, it may be.
Well then, I thank you for what it's worth. God go with you.
I do not trust him. Definitely an order member. Alright, let's go talk to Chatty over here.
How fare you, Lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There's more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That's good to hear.
I just don't like how the other noble here kept trying to kiss my butt. I really don't like that. It does nothing for me. It bothers me a lot. Don't try to puff me up. Alright.
3 men, 3 possible futures.
Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them?
It's not for myself I must cast this stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need?
You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself.
All 3 have strengths and weaknesses.
Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. Lead your shire with pride, ferocious one.
It is decreed by this lawful shire moot that the Ealdorman of Lincolnshire shall be son of our dear and departed Lord Hunbjor, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnshire.
I don't know what to say. I thank you deeply, madly, humbly. What more can I say? I don't know. I miss my father. I'd sooner see him standing here than... Well, I will do my best for each and every one of you.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Ealdorman. As all well know, this Shiremoot's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Ceolwulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Ceolwulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results. Our good and noble friend arbles with.
The septic rot has overtaken this shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Your Grace! What is this?
Nobles of Lincolnshire, stand fast!
For the glory of the ancients, leave none alive!
Not very secret, huh, buddy? Yep, there it is. The name just made sense, too, so... We got it. We're gonna be okay, I think. I've got my dwarven axe, you know? I think we'll be alright. Let's see. Let's toss you over. Oh, nope, you just died. I dealt too much damage now, so it's gonna be hard to, like, toss him around, you know? Are you trying to frickin' bread wedding me, you idiots? Not today. I know we're gonna lose a lot, but that was always gonna happen. Oh, yeah?
Kill these traitors.
That's what you want them to do? Okay, anyway. Let's go again. Let me kill him. Got that guy. Screw your leg.
Is this how that god welcomes a new Ealdorman?
I would hope not. Anyway, let's get him. Kind of stuffy in here. I can't wait to leave. Alright, how many more do I need to kill? Be good, you didn't kill him. We've only got a few more to go after. Oh, he's a much tougher one for sure. Got him. Come on. No crate. I want to see. Oh, well. I think we've got, what, two more? Okay. Let's make it quick. Now one more. Oh, my bad. That happened.
What's his endgame?
This one's gone. Find those who still draw breath. Polish your ass, Hunwald. The Ealdorman's seat is yours. As your war council, I suggest you waste no time in catching this grief totter. You won't be far.
We should first bury our dead, no?
That choice is yours to make, Ealdorman.
Yes. Yes, of course. We'll bury our dead, then raise a feared.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs, and tend to the remaining wounded until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. All right. Now we've got to go do that because, I mean, I don't like that bishop. And we're going to kill him. Let's go do that. We're about to make it there now. Also, I can't really help it whenever the AI runs right into me. Most people should have been against the wall or in a different room, but they ran right into me.
And in broad daylight, the hatred that eats at that man must be ravenous.
Yeah, no kidding.
What news, Hunwald?
We've learned that Herivrith rode for the fort at Anecastre following the massacre. I have assembled a fiat there. Quite a large one, in fact. They eagerly await your orders, Eivor.
You mean your orders, Ealdorman?
Ah, yes, that's right. My orders. Which are what, exactly?
Who can say? Ride with me to your camp, and we'll find out together.
I don't really expect him to be good in times of war.
Herivrith was a friend of my father's and always so dear to me. I don't understand what possessed him.
He invoked the name of an ancient order before his men attacked. I know exactly what possessed him.
Do you?
It's not a story for now.
This will send waves of disgust through all the parishes of Mercia. Herivrith is a new and ugly stain on the bishopric.
Your Christ was an interesting man, if a little soft. But stranger still, I've met so few Christians like him.
Today has been a boon, Eivor. In spite of everything, I now know my father's spirit still burns within me. It's thanks to you I know this. When songs are sung of the day Lincolnshire was saved, your name will ripple through every stanza.
Don't be hasty, Hunwald. One verse of our song remains unsung. The din of battle beckons.
You pagans and your appetite for battle. I certainly don't share it. I worry what diabolical feast the bishop has in store.
Don't let that poxy bishop worry you. With Eivor beside us, he'll be victuals before long. How has Archer taken all this? She and Herivrith were so close.
She must feel as though the devil himself attacked her monastery. A poor lady.
We spoke briefly.
We are the men of Lincolnshire!
Here's the camp, do you see? The fiat will soon be ready for action.
Give them mead and let them rest. There's hard fighting ahead.
Yeah, not bad. You put it all together. Good work. Alright, let's have a chat.
Our warsmith has arrived. The fiats are ready to fight.
Chieftain Eivor, can we win this fight with the men you see assembled here?
If they fight with the bravery of double their number, we may.
And is there room in your Valhalla for a ferocious swan?
Of course. Let fly your glorious banner.
Are we ready then?
We attack now. Ready the fiat.
Our first task will be to breach the outer wall. Then we deal with the troops inside.
Okay, it is time now. We go to war again. It won't be nearly as bad. How does every single enemy have a freaking castle? Damn, that's a lot of them.
To me, holy warriors of Lincolnshire!
Okay.
The best way to breach is with a battering ram. I should help it along.
Yeah, I should, but before I do that, I need to go up. If they've got oil, that won't be fun. Not for anyone involved. Ooh, hoo, hoo, hoo. Pardon me. Gotta move through. Don't bother me. Poink. Got that one. Let's hit what we can, I suppose. Like that guy, for one. Later, pal. Alright, that's only one gone. Let's get the other ones. Nope. I don't want to hit those explosive jars. I'm trying to avoid them. Oh, people made it up here already? That's pretty wild. He nearly knocked me off. I'm just trying to watch out currently. Oh, look who's here. No, I don't think he would have been bad. I just wish he was a bit more direct with me. He kept trying to butter me up, trying to bribe me and crap. Not my thing, dude. Alright, let's get him. Wait, what are you doing here? I think I just hit him, which is hilarious. Alright, I don't want to use the lock one anymore. It's causing me too many issues currently. Oh, got him. Alright, I think they got the first gate. Good job. Someone did bring him up. Good. And he's actually fighting! The guy has really no talent for fighting, but he's doing it. Well, I'm proud of you, kiddo. Let's get more of them. That'll take a moment, but we can cut through them all. For every critical strike, I get to catch my axe on fire, which is great. Oh. I don't know if I want to do that. I mean, I can fight and not have that happen. Oh, wow, they all died. Okay. Interesting. Things look pretty grim here.
Past that palisade. An explosion could do it. Or I could try hitting it with a springhold.
Okay. I gotta change it up a little bit. Gotcha. Alright, well, let me cut through. People keep dying around here. Ah, I see an easy way up. I don't want to have to climb myself. Up we go. Oh yeah, it's going much better now that I'm not locking on. Nope. And he's gone. Alright, let's jump on down. It's what we've got to do. Now, I think I want to blow it up, if I'm able to do that. Yeah, I think I can do that. Let's grab what belongs to me. That belongs to me. Alright, will that do it? Let's find out. Yeah, easy. It only took one. Maybe if you guys didn't give me such a boon in every single battle, that wouldn't happen so much. Okay, let's kill him. Ooh! Yeah, do that later. Very busy right now. Is that a big guy? Sounds like one. Where's all the chainmail, by the way? Oh, he died. Okay, that was cool. Alright. Let's charge it up, man. Check out that damage, huh? Ho-ho-ho. He's on fire now. Hey, put him down! Oh! Crap! I'm going to assume he's going to be okay. Oh, what a way to go. Alright. Let's get inside. Won't be hard. Just got to shoot these and that one. And probably that guy, too. Alright. Let's get down.
Gods. Perifrith has gone mad.
Yeah, tell me about it. Now I just need to kill him.
You, point me to the bishop. No one else need die today.
He's in the chapel there, hiding away. Scabrous coward.
Let no one leave that church without facing judgment.
Tell me about it. All right, on my way there, I'm gonna cut through a few enemies. Thank you, sir, much appreciated. Have a flaming hammer, very comical. All right, it's probably Bard, right?
Blocked from the other side.
Yeah, sure. Would be a shame if I just broke that. Let's kill him. Let's get that guy too. Plant. All right. No, don't kill a child. From the instrument, huh? Oh, there we go. Let me tell you something. Getting onto ladders can be the biggest challenge in the game. Oh god, he's been hanging people like crazy. What a madman. Alright, he should be right over here, or up here. Alright. Is he trying to get away? I suppose so. What a coward. What an idiot. What a maroon, even. Alright. How am I gonna get him? Any guards close by? I hope not. Is he riding away? Oh, he's not. Oh, hi there. Oh, what's up? Huh, it didn't like auto lock onto him. Oh well. That works out. Yoink! Oh, I do have to confirm the kill, so that would have been bad anyway. Now we know who the liar is.
I died the day I hid behind these robes, this cross. To bring the light of my order to a wider view, I did baste myself. Clawed my way to the top of this common religion, full of common men. I should have lived as the ancients did.
That's the folly of mankind, Hiravrid. We wallow in our failures like happy pigs in a sty of shit. You should have learned to enjoy it.
And we won. The end for him. I've been judging a lot of people as of late. A new assault complete. Yeah, I don't expect him to be a war leader right away. People should counsel him. If he listens to wise counsel, that's a good sign. A lot of people around here. How's it going? I do miss using my crew, though. Need them to come join me in the future. Ah, there you are.
Eivor. Is the bishop dead?
He bled too little and talked too much. Now he's gone.
I won't miss him. But Atcha will need some time to grieve.
You fought well, ferocious swan. Notched a few scars in your baby fat today.
Yes, but they will heal. And stronger than before.
Lincolnshire is yours to lead, Ealdorman. The hardest fight begins now.
The din of battle still rings in my ears. I think I now know what it means to be a leader.
Good.
I would ask a favor, if I could.
Name it.
As Ealdorman, my life may be a dangerous one. For a time, anyway. Would you allow my Swanborough to take refuge in your settlement? At least until I feel all danger has passed.
We'd be happy to have her.
Thank you, my sturdy Norse berserker. The mead halls of my shire will be lonely without you stomping about.
Our people are bonded now. We must look out for one another.
Blast it. I am a horror with goodbyes.
It'll do for now.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Randvi. Let's tell her the good news.
Before we do that, though, let's go kill the liar. He won't be hard to find. Yeah, he's right over here. Tadfrid joined the Order almost by accident, a Saxon who fought with the Norse. It's always interesting how it's really about killing their followers, not the major leaders, but we'll go get him anyway. He's not too far away. Now, before we go kill him, let's go do some flighting. I've got to raise up my charisma.
You, Dane, come closer.
What do you want?
You look to be a good fighter, but do you dare to face the greatest battle you will ever know?
Of what do you speak?
I speak of a terrible and monstrous incorporeal power whose name is feared across these lands. Fergal the Faceless, the most fearsome flighter in all of Grantbridgeshire.
Ooh. A flighter, is that all?
Fergal the Faceless has silenced doubters before. Will you challenge him?
I will face the Faceless.
My God.
You are braver than most. Or, perhaps, more foolish. Come, I will give you a key. This key unlocks Fergal's lair, which you see now before you.
That is a house.
No, no. It is a den of nightmares. A pit of death from which few have ever escaped unharmed.
By words. Unharmed by words.
Go. Go now. And God be with you.
Well, he sounds terrifying. Sure. We'll do that. Huh.
A new victim? What fool dares to challenge the might of Fergal the Faceless?
Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Eivor of the Raven Clan? My next meal. Are you prepared to be eviscerated with words?
I think I will survive.
I am Fergal the Faceless, and I am clever and strong. But you're not. You're ugly and weak, and you're a big smelly coward. You're probably too scared to even face me, now that I think about it.
Sorry, have you started?
Yes, obviously. I said you're probably too scared to face me.
You know what? I don't know if he knows how to fight. Huh.
It's the weakest attempt I have yet heard to disgrace me.
Ah, you think you can win with rhyme, do you? Well, if you like to rhyme, listen this time. I'm very brave. My flighting is grave. I'm not a knave, and it's victory that I really crave. Your tongue is fat. You're a sprat. You whine like a little brat. And we are in a spat.
Oh, boy.
Says the flighter who hides in a hole like a rat.
Oh, you've made a terrible mistake. Be ready for my finishing blow. I am the best at flighting. I have got powerful skills. I'm strong as an ox and clever as a fox. I'm sharp as a dozen hawks. Let me show you my skills, and then you I shall kill dead with my skill.
If we are arguing as to your talent, I shall happily die on this hill.
You... Just one moment. I need to think. Give me time.
Fergal the Faceless, or Fergal the Wordless?
No, you get ready. The killing blow is... It's coming. It's...
Fergal? Hello?
Okay, well, I did it. I won. That was strange. I'm gonna go kill that guy now. I need to do another thing. It was a joke flight. Okay. I love that. And I'm nearly at a new level. I wonder what I need to unlock with a higher leveled charisma. Oh, interesting. He likes to play. I do too. How am I gonna do it? Let me think about it. Hold on. Dun, 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 dun. Don't mind me. Goodbye. Okay, he's dead. Time to confirm. Are you dead? Let's find out.
You won. I can see defeat. When Scops mention me, they will sing of my conquests.
Cowards do not get sagas.
I am no coward. In a long-lost battle for Wessex, I was the victor. The Scot could speak of that time. Focus on my lost honor.
No, I'll leave your reputation as it is. Here, in the blood-blackened mud.
Okay. Well, we got him. That's another dead order member. I've killed a lot so far. Okay, we've got to get her. One person wanted to know why I didn't kill her yet, because it's a story kill. I've got to wait until I can kill her in the storyline. Not every kill is related to just me finding them. The Rake. Let's have a look now. Okay, the ruins of a church. Interesting. Yeah. I probably need to do more story stuff. I found no clues over here, which is very interesting. She's probably like the last big one. Then I'll be very close to knowing. I'm very close anyway. I guess we could go talk to Ranvi now. Yeah, why not? I finally got used to my weapon. I'll have to use it again. But I'll probably switch it up and use my daggers and play a little bit more quietly in the future. For like a part or two. Eivor.
Lincolnshire is a friend to us.
Wonderful news. And who is our ally there?
The boy Hunwald is the new Ealdorman of Lincolnshire, and he has sworn allegiance to us.
The loud one, an Ealdorman? Well, should he ever wish to call for aid, he need only shout.
That is true, and we could influence him easily. He would trust us more than any other. Who would be more loyal? Okay, I can build a proper home now, if I want to, for the seer, and I am going to do that. We might as well. It's been a bit. Very nice, okay.
Hey there, how oh. are you?
Pardon me. Yep, typical pet, napping right in the middle where you need to walk. Sounds about right. I do want to put on that Carolingian set eventually. It's very cool looking. I like it a lot. Alright, anyway, let's have a look. I want to build your home, and I want to build it now. Perfect.
This will do. Thank you, Eivor.
Anything to help you feel at home.
I am most at home helping others. May we return to the subject of your visions?
We could, if you think it worth something.
I need one more ingredient to finish an elixir for you. Look around the pond there. You will find what I require. Once brewed, this elixir will help you dive deeper into your visions, to see them more clearly.
Okay. And we can do that. I'll probably need to dedicate an entire part to it, which I could do soon. I know a few people want to see it, and I have no idea what the contents are, but I know it shall take some time. I do know that much. Alright, well, we shall call it here, everyone. Thank you for watching, and look forward to more tomorrow.